Yeah. Yeah! Yeah!
I've already told you what really.
I am honored that you should.
What happened with the.
Nothing out of the ordinary. He came to test his mettle like everyone, but he couldn't even get past young Weed. Then he started whining about getting his money back because we tricked him, so.
But you didn't.
No! And when he got really annoying, he got a punch in the mouth, and he hasn't been back since. Doesn't dare to. But it didn't shut.
I heard that someone's looking for men willing to do anything.
Willing to do anything? Meaning what? Something filthy like helping the knacker? I wouldn't know. Go and ask.
That's not what I meant, but all right. Let's fight.
Not so fast, lad. First you'll have to prove your worth. Go around with Weed, and then you.
Fine.
May the Lord watch over you.
God save you. Let's do it.
Let's go.
May the Lord watch over.
Let's fight.
That wasn't bad.
God be with you.
I want to fight you.
What did I tell you? First beat Weed and those three clowns.
Good luck to you.
God save you.
Let's fight.
You look pretty good.
We'll see.
God be with you.
I want to fight you.
What did I tell you?
Take care.
God be with you.
I want to fight you.
What did I tell you? First beat Weed and those three clowns.
Sure. Farewell.
Hey, you! Halt!
Surrender!
All right, you've committed a violation. Someone saw you stealing.
This definitely won't...
Just my... Look, I can't tell you it.
Well, I thought...
Creep around in the dark without a light. Where's your torch?
I want to fight.
What did I tell you? First beat Weed and...
Take care.
What are you doing here? What are you doing here? Are you after something? Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing here?
Yeah. Yeah.
I hope I can.
Let's fight.
That wasn't.
May the Lord watch over.
Bala!
I want to fight you.
You put on quite a show. Can't say I expected it.
Been a pleasure.
Hey, who's guard. There?
You're Christ, quick.
A thief!
There's a thief over there!
I see a thief!
Guard!
Mother of God.
Who's there?
What the?
That was pretty good. I didn't think you had it in you.
You were really good. I've got to hand it to you. Most lads don't make it past me. So listen, I want to tell you something.
What's that?
There are people here looking for really tough men, and I'd say you fit the bill. So when you walk through town this evening, if there's a light in the church, go in. And wait a while. If they like the looks of you, they might give you some work.
Thanks. I'll think about it. Look here, lads. I hope I won't be seeing you around here again. Go and find some other place for your games.
All right. We'll go. But if you want to fight again, you're always welcome. I bet you'll come off worse next time. Good luck to you.
Yeah. Yeah.
I hope I can be of help.
I've taken care of the lads who were bothering you. You'll have a quiet evening tonight.
God bless you, lad. And here's something for your trouble and kindness. Unlike that miserable bailiff.
If anything else grieves you, just say the word.
Take care now.
Henry's come to see us.
Aha. It's you.
How are you doing? Feeling better yet?
Aye, much better. I'm truly grateful. A bit longer and I'll be able to run back to the woods and carry on. Well, never mind. Very kind of you to look in on me.
Truth be told, I didn't come just for your health.
What do you need?
Well, I've heard tell there's work for fearless men who enjoy a bit of silver.
Ah, I believe I can help you with that. They used to frequent the tavern, but now they meet in the church.
The church?
Aye, that's right. The church is locked at night, but if you see a light, the door will be open. Go in there and wait. Say a prayer or something, and then you'll see.
That's it. I don't need to speak to anyone.
Just doing what I told you is enough. They'll give you a good look over and see if you've got the metal. Don't you worry about that.
All right, thank you.
You took care of me, why wouldn't I help you? Tit for tat, eh?
God be with you.
Yeah.
Lord be with you.
Bye. Let's have a word.
Well...
is this enough?
See now?
Good luck then. Let's talk about the prop.
Well...
since it's you...
that's still... aye. God save you.
I have that cloth for you.
Ah, excellent. Here's your reward. Good luck, Ben.
I've got some goods.
All right. God be with you.
We do some... what do you...
that's still...
you're...
we're getting there. See now?
Yeah. I'm at your service.
I notice the targets. Are you?
I notice you're asking questions. Are you the Inquisition by any?
No, I'm Henry.
From Skalitz. I'm Vate, from here. What?
It's a...
Try your hand, do you? I know plenty who do. When you can...
I've got no idea what you're talking.
Never played chumps? And you call yourself an archer? Chumps is a game for real archers. It tests your strength, stamina, and accuracy. And it can be a nice little earner. Unless you're well...
So what exactly is...
I'll tell you. A bunch of logs are floated down the river. Then you count to 20, and the archers run along the banks after the logs. At the end of the course, someone collects all the logs and counts the strikes. Whoever has the most, always meaning me, wins the bout.
Each archer has 20 arrows with their own colored fletching, and the contest ends when the last log floats through the finish line.
Sounds like good fun.
Fun? My friend, it will bring you out in a proper sweat, and you'll be well pleased to hit just one or two blocks. So how about it then? Fancy a bout? You'll need your own bow, but I'll supply the arrows with cup.
Absolutely.
Come on then. Ah, one more chump. Now you have to bet at least 10 groschen, 50 at most. There'll be three archers, so how much will you bet?
You only live once.
That's the betting over.
Farewell.
And now, I'll see you at the finish.
I've got this easy. You've no chance against me, amateurs.
Almost had it.
Bloody hell, the wind took it. Almost had it.
Almost had it.
Oh, well, I won't miss the next one.
Hit home.
Got it. Another on target.
I won't miss the next one.
Got it!
Missed. home. Almost had it. Hit.
Time's up, folks. One more arrow, and that's it.
Hit.
Look out. So, how did it go?
Well done, Henry. You've come first. It looks like you really do know what you're doing with a bow. You're still not up to my standard, mind you, but a pretty good effort. Here are your winnings. I hope you'll wager them on some chumps again. Good luck to you.
I'd like to try chumps one more time.
Of course. Ah, one more chump. So how much will you bet?
No half measures. What's there to save for anyway?
That's the betting over with. Now here are your arrows. Take care now.
Another on target.
Hit.
Another on target. Got it.
Got it.
Another on target. Got it. Let's see you beat that. You've no chance against me, amateurs. I've got this easy. Hit.
Hit.
Yeah.
God save you.
Is something troubling you?
I wouldn't say it's troubling me exactly, my boy, but I've heard talk about the Susso blacksmith and I'm losing sleep over.
What talk might that be?
They say they've heard him chanting when he tempers steel, and that nothing of his ever breaks.
Using spells to strengthen steel? That sounds like old wives' tales to me.
That's what they say. They say he's always muttering something, and if anyone catches him at it, he stops at once and gives them dirty looks.
Maybe he's just praying.
Well, he's getting help of some sort, whether it's prayers or something less holy.
Well, if it's troubling you, go and have a look for yourself.
Easy for you to say. I have too much work to do. And anyway, I can't just turn up asking questions. He wouldn't tell me anything.
And how could I help with that?
Simple enough. Go there and find out if there's any grain of truth in it.
I suppose asking costs nothing.
Just don't ask him outright about any sorcery.
Don't worry, I'm not that daft.
Good, good. And don't worry. You won't be the poorer for it. Once you find out what's what, I'll find a way to recompense you.
All right.
Good. But be subtle about it. Don't go embarrassing yourself. Or me. Take care now.
Yeah.
way!
I've decided what to build.
That shouldn't take too long. Come along with me and we'll take a look at the site.
We're going to build here?
Right here.
I'm ready.
I'll just quickly check again that we have everything we need. All good.
Looking for something around here.
Who are you?
I'm glad to see you.
You've no business here. Never mind making yourself comfortable in someone's...
This won't take long. Take that. Got weak at the knees, have you? You'll get what for. Not a good move, you do. Where could he have vanished to? He must be here. Is that all you've got? I'll wring your neck, you cur. Damn! Take that! Had enough of life, have you? No!
just when I wanted to vent my rage on someone. Ha! Yeah!
Well, well, now what do we have here?
I'll slay you, you scum. You know how... Cunt!
Ready to bleed.
I'm going to enjoy this.
No, no!
Earth it!
Yeah.
word, if you please.
We've met before, haven't we?
We have. And you defeated me in combat.
Why would I want to fight you?
Ad honorem, friend. For honor. For the thrill of combat.
Well, if that's how you look at it.
So, shall we cross swords?
Why not? I could use a little exercise.
Excellent. I see you have no fear. Let's get to it, then. Insolent whelp!
You're going to cry now. Kunda.
You've won honorably, sir.
Thank you.
God's blessings. What can I do for you?
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Let's talk about...
Well...
Agree?
You weren't convinced.
Are we agreed?
Come now. See now? I knew we'd come to an...
Goodbye.
Let's talk about...
Well...
Agree?
Less.
What about this?
That's better. All right, so?
Be with you.
Can we do something about the price?
All right, sir.
What about this?
That's not enough.
All right. And now?
Well, now. Aye.
God be with you.
Let's talk. Agree?
You're all right.
Since it's you.
A nice sum. All right, so?
Yeah! Yeah!
My good man, how about a little wager? We've met before, haven't we?
Come to think, yes, we have.
So, you know how it goes. The bet is 5 groschen. I'll give you a
That sounds good. Let's do it.
Pay close attention. There was once a merchant who had a magic pouch. When the merchant put 1 coin in it and waited overnight, he found 2 coins in it the next day. So, he waited until the following morning, and lo and behold, there were now 4 coins. And the morning after that, there were 8, and so on and so forth. After 60 days, the pouch was completely full. My question's this. In how many days would the pouch have filled up if the merchant had put in 2 coins instead of 1 on the first day?
Can you repeat that?
Certainly. There was once a merchant who had a magic pouch. So, he waited until the following morning, and after 60 days, the pouch was completely full. My question's this. In how many days would the pouch have filled up if the merchant had put in 2 coins instead of 1 on the first day? No, the correct answer's 59. It may seem that the pouch will fill in only half the time, but in fact, you will save only the first day when the 1 coin multiplied to become 2. Oh, don't you fret.
Not if I see you first.
Yeah.
Day to you.
They say you're the best blacksmith in the whole region. That metal you've tempered never breaks.
Ah, nothing but old wives' tales. Of course, some of my pieces have broken, but only ever here at the smithy.
No one's ever returned anything for you to rework, though, have they?
Not that I recall, but I can't remember everything.
I understand. I remember Father always heated up the iron until it was bright red, just starting to turn bright yellow. The furnace hummed gently and glowed, and then the water hissed. There was sweat on our foreheads too.
Fine words, and no mistake. I do it a little differently.
I heat until the metal is 2-3 shades short of bright yellow. I ease up on the bellows, and after a Lord's Prayer and a Hail Mary, off it goes into the water.
It's strange to think that I'll never help him out with it again. Our forge will stay burned out forever, unless I go back to the trade myself.
It would be a shame not to, lad. Working iron is a worthwhile thing. Godly. It makes life easier for folk. And, let's be honest, you can make a decent living doing it.
Thank you. It was good to remember how my life used to be.
Maybe you'll have the good fortune to return to your trade.
And when you quench, there's nothing special you do?
Well, that depends. I heat it up again after that, but not so it starts to glow. I just hold it like this at the edge of the furnace for a while, and then quench it again.
You quench twice?
Yes, although there's less quenching needed the second time. It doesn't get quite so hot.
And how does that help?
I don't rightly know. I found out about it by chance. I got caught short, needed to piss so bad, I left the rod resting by the furnace by mistake. That's how I found out if you quench twice, it doesn't break as easily. No idea why, but I've tried it enough times to know it works.
I'd like to ask you about...
And I'd say I've nothing much to tell you. You just need an eye for it and a furnace.
Let's stop talking about tempering.
Farewell.
I hope I can be of help.
Any chance of some work?
Well, come to think, there is one rather delicate matter to attend to. A while ago, a holy man came by here. He said he'd come from the Holy Land, and he was selling various relics he'd collected on his travels to pay his way.
I see.
Well, I heard he had some fragments of a sacred sword that once belonged to the fabled Czech Queen of Sheba. But by the time he reached me, he had no pieces left of the sword. All he had was some dubious wares, splinters from our Lord's cross, thorns from the crown, nothing of interest to me.
And where did the pieces of the sword go?
He sold them off to swordsmiths and blacksmiths hereabouts. They just keep them lying around at home for good luck. If I had them, I'd forge them back into a sword. Can you even imagine what power it would command? If you could get me all the pieces of the sword, I'd repay you very handsomely.
Isn't it a bit strange that some pilgrim would have something so valuable?
Are you suggesting you might have been lying? Well, people aren't to be trusted, but this is nothing to joke about. God would smite him in a flash if he made light of holy relics that way.
Where can I find them?
Like I said, the smith hereabouts bought them from him. They say the largest piece is with the Rat-Eye swordsmith. The bastard probably won't want to sell. But if you manage to swipe it somehow...
I could do with a sword like that. What if you sold it to me?
Well, everything has its price. But this one would be expensive. Getting hold of the bits is one thing. Forging them back together is quite another. That tinkerer from Rat-Eye couldn't manage it.
It does sound very...
Excellent. You'll see... Take care.
Hey, you! Halt! Surrender!
You were seen thieving.
Well, you won't forget this in a hurry, because it'll take a nice pile of coin to fix it.
Oh, well.
All right. Just make sure. Give me all the things you stole, so I can return.
Yeah.
God be with you.
Master Blacksmith, I think I know how the tempering gets done in Sassau.
And what have you found out? Don't keep me on tenterhooks. Out with it.
He heats it up to red, three steps away from yellow, and then stops heating, says the Lord's Prayer, and quenches.
I'll be damned. That's pretty much what I do too. Except I just count.
I'm just saying what I found out.
That's as may be. But there must be something else he does differently if he does the quenching just like I do.
He said he repeats the tempering straight after, but only warming up the iron, so it never even turns red.
Tempering twice in a row? Why would he do that?
He said it happened by chance once, and he noticed it made everything stronger, so now he does it that way all the time.
Well, there's no harm in trying it out, is there?
Are you satisfied?
You did what I asked of you, so I'm at your service. And here's something to keep you going.
I've heard that some time ago, a pilgrim from the Holy Land was selling a few relics. Did he come by here and offer you part of a sword?
Would it surprise you if I said yes? Why do you ask?
I'd buy the piece from you.
Well, why not? I don't know why I let myself get bamboozled into buying it. It's quite useless, and I can't say I've had good luck ever since.
Since it's you...
You won't convince me...
Are we agreed?
Well, I'll... Goodbye.